Welcome to the vlog.
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 Welcome to the fucking vlog, season two.
Welcome to the vlog.
Having a morning routine that I can do that feels self-carry is very important, and it was nice to start the week off like this. I really took my time when I was doing it, and I got to gua sha my face a little bit, which is always nice. It's just like a little massage.
I don't know if you can see it on my chest, but like there's the rash is like little patches here, and it's like scabs here. I have it like on my arm here and here. I literally look insane. I just want to get like a good shot of the.
I worked for a little bit before walking over to my grandparents' house to spend time with family.
Buttons and a key. The buttons and key.
Nice.
We watched the Olympics for a little bit. My grandmother gave us such a good lunch. Then we took Aria out to the park and we got her some Orangina first.
Need a jump? Look at how she's balancing.
So sad saying bye. Afterwards, I went on a ride with my dad and my sister, and we got home and made pizza.
I dropped a bottle of Gungura on the floor.
I need a break?
Oh, yeah.
Is it floss?
Yep.
Oh, no. And how do they handle it?
I didn't care.
Yeah.
Staff and Grammy, the family pizza cutter. She's been cutting pizza for her family for a long time. Don't get it twisted. This is how it's done.
Good news, baddies. I had a whole night of sleep last night. I think even Turner forgot to set his alarm, so I slept in until 7:30. Around. So I woke up and I was like, oh, like I feel very rested. Wow. And I turned over and Turner was there and I'm like, isn't he up to work? And we looked at, and I like looked at the watch and I was like, oh shit. So I was like, hey, did you not set an alarm? I think he was a little nervous at first, but when he saw that it was only like 7:30, he was a little more chill and he was able to get to work on time. So that's good. I'm just about to do my work. Very hot in this room right now though.
After working for a bit, I biked over to my therapy appointment, and that went pretty well. Since I was in the area, I went up to meet with Gia for lunch, and it was really nice to see her. And then I went to get waxed.
I was waxing my legs, and then granddaughter duty called, so I have to go and get batteries for my grandparents and try to fix something there. But I am only halfway through my legs.
Like, all of the upper part of the leg is still needed to be done, and like the knee of this leg is still needed. So that's pretty funny, but I'll have to go help them.
I helped my grandfather for a little bit before heading home, and I changed to go meet Molly, Jerry, and my mom. Jerry was visiting Molly from Nova Scotia, and she had talked about him all the time, but I finally got to meet him in person, and it was so nice to see like a friend from her first year at McMaster. And then I met up with Gemma. We hung out at the distillery and we got such good cocktails. Like, it was funny. We both didn't like each other's, but we liked our own, which was nice. And then got home and I finally got a fan, which I was excited about. On Wednesday, I painted my nails like a yellow color and I did a lot of work. In the afternoon, I got to work out and do a bit of grocery shopping.
I'm about to head out to go to my grandparents. Today has not been fun. We're supposed to go to Whistler this weekend, and there's just a lot of things that are happening that are getting in the way of us getting our reservation. There, we might have to finagle some certain against the rule things to get it. So we'll see. I am doing my best to pull strings. Going to my grandparents now, gonna have dinner, and hopefully this can all get figured out.
Got to my grandparents, and my grandmother had prepared us such a nice dinner, but we were really missing the rest of our family now that they left to go back to Rwanda. But it was nice to visit them, and always is. And then afterwards, I met up with Nicole at Earl's because we were kind of panicking about the Whistler thing, and we just wanted to de-stress together. So we had a couple drinks together and it tasted very good and it was just super fun. On Thursday, as per usual, I had to do quite a bit of work and my chair actually broke, which sucked, but I still made some chickpeas. I had my weekly meeting with Haiju, did some grocery shopping, and then I had a call with Georgia and Nicole to discuss some stuff for Whistler.
I'm off to get dinner with friends. I haven't seen Tay in a really long time. And honestly, I haven't seen Matthias in a hot minute either. So it's going to be nice to see everybody. My meeting for tomorrow got canceled. So I essentially have all of tomorrow off. So I'm just going to use the morning to do all of my prep stuff for the trip. Then Victor is going to pick me up. He's driving me out there. And that's when we're going to see if we can get into the hotel. As I mentioned before, Whistler has a stupid rule about how you need to be 25 to book most of the places there. So I've asked our family friend Xiang to help me, and she's very kindly said that she will do this for us. Like, actually such a lifesaver. I can't believe that it's kind of working out, but I don't know, I feel very hopeful about it. Stay tuned. I guess when you're watching it, you'll only have to watch a couple more minutes to find out whether or not we made it. Fingers crossed. I had such a good time with Earls, with everybody. It was really fun.
It is the Taeyangbae.
How are you?
Got myself a watermelon mule.
Oh, I like his shirt.
He's very fashionable, at least.
Had a quinoa power bowl, and I just was like enjoying the company so much. I miss everybody a lot. What's up, you guys? So I'm back from Earl's and I had a great night. It was so good to see everybody and to catch up. We were there for like 3 hours. It did not feel that long. It was great. Tomorrow's nice because I don't actually have like a ton of work. I don't have any work meetings, so I don't have to like prepare for anything in the morning. So I'm not gonna set an alarm and just let myself wake up naturally. I'm gonna pack and get ready to go. I'm certain this trip's gonna turn out great. I'm really excited. I had such a chill morning, just ate, worked out, and took my time.
Got all my groceries for the trip, and now essentially I am just waiting for Victor to pick me up, and we're hoping that everything goes well. Weirdly, I got an email from the hotel, and they just sent me all the check-in information, and they're like, call us when you get here and we'll buzz you up. It sounds like nobody's meeting us now, which is just weird. Me and Xiang are still gonna check in because, just in case, together. It's so weird. It's so chaotic. Ugh, whatever.
The boys picked me up and we had a great ride filled with conspiracy theories from Rory's life up there. We stopped at Tim Hortons and we got there quite quickly, and we couldn't check in right away, so we stopped by a river and the boys had a beer. I was too nervous to drink.
What? Can't do it?
Oh, that's some cold water, yeah.
This is the moment of truth. I'm literally standing outside the hotel. And we will see if everything works out. I'm kind of freaking out, but I'm hoping everything's gonna be okay. Everything was okay.
Jesus fucking menace, eh? Jesus!
Yeah, it's good.
This is such a funny shot.
This place is fire.
Okay, good to know. We lost Rory. What's up, you guys? We made it to Whistler. I actually can't believe we're here. Driving? Even though weather's shit? Is Georgia shotgunning?
Oh.
Is this for real right now?
She looks like she's in pain. You can straight up sleep on her. Yo.
I'm not sleeping over her. You're a queen for doing that.
Once we were all together, we decided to go out, so we put our names down at Earl's, but they said it was going to be a long wait, so we got in at the Keg, which was better anyway, because we had to live up to the meme last time. I actually really enjoyed our time here, and the best part was that we got these loaves of bread that we got to eat, and it definitely revived some of us. And then in the rain, we ran over to Earl's, and we had to celebrate something very important. Columbia fleece, H&M sweats. What are you wearing, Miranda?
outfit from last night plus a hoodie.
What about you, Nicole? What you wearing?
Sweatsuit.
What you wearing, Georgia?
Earth,
yeah. Cute. Baddies on the roll.
We found the cutest breakfast place that the girls were able to just get a breakfast together. I had like kind of an English breakfast looking thing. And then we went back and got some purebred. I got something for Turner. We chilled at the house for maybe 30 minutes, but we wanted to go out into the village and maybe shop for a bit. Our original plan was to go to Aritzia, but it was closed, so we decided to go visit Miranda, who was doing a course at her cabin there. It was a very pretty cabin, and it was nice to spend her lunch break with her. Then our plan was to go to Victor's friend's cabin out near Green Lake. So the boys took the first cab. We danced in the room for a little bit before finally heading out to get there.
No, don't you dare.
Don't.
Drove us home, and we encountered into a torrential downpour for a couple minutes there, which sucked.
I'm trying to figure out their cab, and we're in the rain.
Oh, it's like torrential downpour.
Jesus, mom, for the money. I'm trying to be a mom, but I can't do it.
I love you.
Garbage, you twat.
No, because that garbage is gonna stay there overnight, Turner. That's not gonna make it. It's gonna make it smell worse.
What does it matter? We can hardly smell in the first place.
Only 7 o'clock. It's 7 o'clock.
In the evening, we went to a really yummy pizza place, which was much needed. I hadn't really eaten like a good meal since breakfast, so I absolutely mucked there. We were just having a good time out in the village.
Roast beef.
Roast beef.
And we went into the hot tub in the evening, and we also had Rory escapade over to our room. I don't know why he did that.
Yeah.
We all just chilled out in our room till pretty late. It was nice, except for Roy, I think, got knocked out again. On Sunday, Miranda left pretty early because she had to take an exam, and we had to unfortunately pack all the rooms.
Three people waiting for me to try and jump in and steal this thing.
Your life is a I'm not helping you.
Roy, you're so special. You went to the car and just
drive. No, I'm literally going to tell you, might just see me tell her that. And be like, open the door. What? And I'm gonna jump that.
I don't
know.
No, I have another pair.
Then why are you wearing these ones?
They're not even a pair. They're not even a pair.
I have no respect for Earls.
It's not a pair.
We got seated for an Earls brunch, and it was actually very good.
A what?
Espresso martini.
I got a forager omelette that was really good and had a lot of mushrooms. Unfortunately, Victor was not doing well at this point in the day. Then Victor drove us up to Pemberton. I hadn't been before. We went to a lake first and just sat on the dock for a while and talked to each other. And then we drove into the actual little town of Pemberton. And it was really nice. I hadn't been before. We stopped at a little cafe and got some coffee. This was a cute little dog I saw. And then we decided to go to a restaurant. So we walked around town first to try and look for something. And then eventually we settled on this one place. And it kind of had like a mini grocery store on the inside. I got a gomai. Nicole got potatoes. And Zach and Victor both got burgers. And then after that, we were just so tired. And we drove back. I kind of fell asleep for most of the ride. But Victor very kindly dropped me off at my door, even though he hates Charmian Vancouver. Thank you so much. And then I had to do some work.
Kind of annoyed right now because of everything that's going on with work. Like, essentially, I just was sent like a ton of emails today about how they want to add like another table to the paper that's due tomorrow. So I've just been spending the last hour and a bit getting everything ready, and I think I'm almost ready to send it off. I'm just waiting for confirmation about one more thing, but yeah, it's still just not what I wanted. I was
hoping to just relax tonight, but that's not the case. I guess it's almost over.
Okay, here we are. I just put something together. I don't have the energy to really too much effort into the outfit today. I'm just like tired. I'm excited to see people. It's just that the whole work thing kind of took it out of me. I wish I was in a better mood, but I'm not right now. But I am certain I will get into it once I see everybody at the table.
Grace won a raffle for like the Ruts people, and we were able to get some stuff for free. Shout out Grace for making this happen. You're a hard-working woman. And it was super tasty. I absolutely mucked.
While I was taking the 19 home, she goes past the stop at Cordero, and I pull the string as I usually do, and she just drives straight past Denman, and the next stop after that is like the Bay One station at Stanley Park. So essentially, she had to drive all the way into Stanley Park, into the Rose Garden, and then come back. So that happened, and then like I'm still getting emails from work right now, which isn't fun. I'm just a little frustrated, but dinner was good. Had some cauliflower wings and had a gourmet. I tried to order the sour. I know it tasted good because my friends got it, but the sour never ended up coming, and I kind of just took it as a sign. I'm like, maybe you just don't drink tonight. So yeah, I go home, should look at what's going on with work. Okay, so good news. I thought I fucked up, but I didn't actually fuck up, which is good. It was just like a misunderstanding of units. Yeah, but I am gonna go to bed now. But it was a great week. It was a wonderful weekend. I had so much fun with my friends. You know, like sometimes you wanna go back in time and I wish I could. I'm kind of brain dead right now, so I think I'll just end it. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you next week.